Hello kids, welcome to my channel Kahani Didi. Today I'm going to tell you a very interesting story. Story about a boy and a witch. The name of the story is So a Witch. So let's start the story. Viru was an adventurous bright boy. His teacher Dharmendra was very fond of him. When Viru completed his studies, he told his teacher, "Guruji, you have given me so much knowledge. Is there anything I can do for you in return?" His teacher smiled and replied, "I taught you because it was my duty, not for any reward. But there is something that I have always wanted, and I think only you can get it for me. Legend has it that the gods created a book of knowledge into which they poured their divine learnings. But it got into the hands of a witch who has kept the book with her ever since. People say she lives high up in the remotest corner of the Himalayas. Only the bravest and strongest of men can hope to get there and retrieve that book. I think you are such a person. If you do get this book, you will do all of mankind the greatest service." Viru was charged up with enthusiasm when he heard the story. "I will go there and get the book," he declared. "Then keep these three pebbles," his teacher said. "Use them only when you don't know what else to do." Viru set off with the three pebbles in his pocket. After a long and difficult journey of many days, he reached the witch's lair. The witch was fast asleep inside her cottage. Viru spotted the book lying on a table near her bed. It was a large, heavy book, and he realized it would not be easy to run away with it. So he threw a pebble at the book and said, "Make the book small." Immediately, the book became the size of a small piece of paper. Viru tiptoed into the room and picked it up. No sooner had he slipped it into his pocket than the witch woke up. She grabbed him and said, "Aha, a human, yum. I have not eaten tender man meat for a long time. Come, my little raisin, let me eat you in a gulp." Viru was not scared. He smiled politely and said, "Sure, but let me go to the lake and freshen up. I'm dirty after my long journey." The witch agreed. She tied a rope around his waist and let him go out to the lake to clean up. Viru untied the rope, slipped it around the tree trunk, placed the second pebble near the tree and whispered to it, "Talk like me." Then he quietly ran off from there. The witch waited for some time for Viru to come back. When there was no sign of him, she jerked the rope and shouted, "Are you there?" The pebble replied in Viru's voice, "Yes, I'm here." After some time, the witch shouted out to Viru again, and once more the pebble replied in his voice. This happened a few more times, but the witch was getting very angry. Finally, she gave the rope a hard pull. The tree came flying out, uprooted. She understood that she had been tricked and went after Viru at great speed. But Viru had got a good start. He threw the third pebble and made it create mountains, rivers, volcanoes, and other obstacles for the witch. When he reached his teacher, he handed the book to him and begged to be hidden somewhere. Quickly, his teacher found a hiding place for him. Then he calmly went about cooking a meal. Some days later, the witch arrived huffing and puffing. "Where is that boy?" she shrieked. "I know he is hiding here. I can smell him. Hand him to me." "Certainly," replied Dharmendra, "but first eat something. You must be hungry." And he served the witch a simple meal of chapatis and vegetables. The witch gobbled down the strange food. When she finished and had burped happily, she began to feel sleepy. Then Dharmendra said, "How could Viru escape from someone as strong and clever as you? Perhaps your strength is just a myth. I don't believe it." The witch chuckled. "You want me to show you how strong I am? Come on, test me? Dharmendra quickly said, become as big as a mountain and touch the sky. The witch swelled up and touched the sky. Okay, now become as small as a seed, Dharmendra challenged. Without thinking, the witch turned herself into a tiny seed. Quickly as a flash, Dharmendra picked her up and sowed her deep into the earth, where she lay trapped forever. The plant that grew out of the witch seed was a soybean plant. Soybean contains a lot of strength, so eating soybean will make you as strong as the witch. So kids, I hope you liked today's story. If you liked the story, then definitely share it with your loved ones and don't forget to subscribe my channel Kahani Didi for such lovely and interesting stories. That's all for now. Take care. Bye-bye kids.